This section we'll talk about the legends and how they can be utilized to plot our data on the maps. So basically, we saw that there were two types of legends available. One was our predefined legends, and one was our automatic color legends. Okay. So basically, what legends do, we all know that they allow us to define the range of values, and colors are associated with each of the ranges so that the data could be plotted on the map accordingly. Okay. So when you're defining these legends in the system, predefined legends, you must understand the range of values for your data. So because if you do not understand, then it's difficult for us to add ranges to our data. Hence, they would not be of much value to us when we are talking about plotting the data on the maps. Okay. So in the maintenance app, I think Pramil showed you in the pivot tables demo how we can add the different legends into the system. But in the maps app, we'll go through how these predefined legends add more value to the information when you're displaying them on the map. Okay. So let's try to create a map where we can use this predefined legends. Okay. So let's click on add layer and click on the click on the thematic layer. We'll use the immunization examples here. So let's use immunization and use BCG coverage. Let's go to the period and switch this to last year. And we can plot the data at district level and the coefficient. Okay. Now let's click on add layer to see the map. Okay. So now you see here that legend has already been predefined to the map that we were creating. And the ranges which have been defined here are 0 to 70, which is classified as low, 70 to 80, which is classified as mid, 80 to 90, which is classified as high, and 90 to 100, which is classified as highest, and anything above 100 is classified as invalid. Okay. So now if we go and have a look at our style, we see that this legend set is already selected. Because when we were creating this indicator, we had already assigned this legend set API coverage to our indicator. Okay. So when you are selecting your BCG coverage indicator or any other indicator which has a legend already assigned to it, then that legend would automatically get picked in the map application when you are displaying the data on the maps. Okay. So in the indicators or data elements where you have already defined a legend while creating or while configuring these data elements or indicators, then those are picked by default when you're selecting those from the data field. So whenever you select any indicator or data element which has a predefined legend associated, it will just get added here on the legend set, which gets selected by default. Now let's see this map. Now we have these custom legends which we had set here. So now in a single view, you can see that what are the districts which have a low coverage. And since they're highlighted in this red color, that means that these are the lowest performing districts for the BCG coverage. Okay. And now you see here that the cutoffs here are also kind of less arbitrary. They are more precise that if it's 0 to 70%, that means that's low BCG coverage. If it's within 70 to 80, that means it's mid BCG coverage, needs improvement. High is 80 to 90, highest is 90 to 100. So you don't have arbitrary distributions of values as we saw in automatic legends, because there the distribution happens on the fly. Here, the distribution happens on the basis of the fixed values which you have already provided to this respective indicator through the legend which you created. Okay. Now, it would make more sense to add the names to these districts so that they could be easily highlighted. Right now, the names are shown only when I hover over a particular district boundary. Okay. But if I go to my thematic layer, I go to style, I click on labels, and I click on update layer. Okay. So I'll see the names also now got populated for each of these districts. Okay. So now it kind of helps you to identify these district through the name which is displayed as the label. Okay. So you could again check this data through this predefined legend, and it kind of gives you a clear picture that which of the districts in the entire country need much more effort or an intervention in order to improve their BCG coverages. Okay. Now you could again drill down this information to see that if there are specific facilities which are contributing to this low coverage. Okay. So if you right click on any of the red districts, so let's zoom in a little and look at the bird district, which is in red. Okay. Now, if you right click, some options are available here, which can be further utilized to further analyze the map which you have created. Okay. So if you want to see any information associated with this respective district, then there are some functionalities available where you could see the infrastructural information for that respective district or health facility. So for example, so you choose what data elements you want to see as infrastructure data elements. So example, you have added that population is one of your infrastructural information which you want to see, that what's the overall population for that respective district, the bird district. And then you can also go through the different periods where the data has been reported. So the population data is available here. Next, if you want to drill down to see this data at the facility level, okay, so we can say drill down one level. So it will drill it down and take you to these individual health facilities and the coverage of vaccine, the BCG at that individual facility, to see that which are the facilities which are performing very poor in terms of the BCG coverage. Okay. So you can see that these Crow Health Center, the Pigeon Primary Health Center, Woodpecker, these are the ones which are performing poorly amongst the district, which might be pulling down the overall coverage percentage for that respective district. Okay. So this drill down could help you to further analyze the facilities which are performing low and which may need more. Say you can do a kind of a root cause analysis to understand why these facilities are performing low in terms of BCG coverage. Are there supply issues, HR issues, any other thing which could be contributing to this low coverage? Then you could kind of identify what facilities to work upon and how, and then of course carry out further interventions as needed. Okay. So again, if you want to switch back to the district level, then you can click on any health facility and click on drill up one level. So it will again take you back to the district level. Okay. So likewise, you can practice the drilling down of the health facilities. So if you look at the other district, then you see that most of them are like three of them are performing good. Three of them are performing on an average level. So that kind of contributes overall 81% coverage of the CAT district. Okay. So this is how you can utilize the option to kind of drilling options to see the data at the respective levels, at the district and also at the health facility. Okay. So this is how we can use the drilling down options and how the predefined legends kind of add more value to the information, because you have set legends to look at, and then you can even drill down those legends to the individual facility level. Okay. Next, we'll talk about the data table and the download function. So let's switch back to our earlier use case that we're using for HIV tests performed. Let me look at my chart. Okay. This is the one. Let's look at So this is the one which we created in the morning. Now, if you want to look at the data table, then you click on these more actions icon and select data table. Now this will give you a tabular version of the data which you have already plotted on the map. Okay. So it shows you the ID of that respective health facility, the name, the values which have been reported for that respective period which is selected, the range it lies into, the levels, and which is the parent and the point. So basically we were analyzing the facility layer and the type here is point, and this facility belongs to the dog district. This is the value which has been reported, and this is the range in which the value falls based on the legend which you have selected during creating this respective map. Okay. Now each of this particular field here is searchable. You can add filters here to kind of change the data in the map and the table itself. Okay. So if you want to see the number of facilities who had performed greater than 6,000 tests, so then as soon as you put an expression greater than 6,000, you'll see that the map has changed and it has filtered only those health facilities where the testing volume is greater than 6,000, okay? But you can also add combined filters as well, okay? So now you also want to say greater than 6,000, but less than 15,000, okay? So you'll put an and sign here. And we'll put another condition less than 15,000. Okay. So then the map and the table will filter the results for you and show you only those facilities which had greater than 6,000 tests done, but less than 15,000 tests done. Okay. So then you can add these filters here and modify the map accordingly through these data tables. Okay. Then there is also, if you remove this filter, you can also sort the information on the data table by clicking on the header. Okay. So if you want to sort this information in terms of highest testing done by which facility and the lowest testing done by which facility, so you can do these sortings by clicking on the value header here and it will do this sortings for you. Okay. So this is how you can further play with the data or make combinations of data and use that combination to further analyze or study the map through the data tables. Okay. If you click on the cross button, you can click on the cross button and it will move away the data table. In case you want it back again, then you can click on data table. And the table comes back again and you can do the filtering of data wherever applicable. Okay. Then if I want to use this map which I've created for downloading this map and as an image and use it for my external documents, then I can click and download. It will ask you certain options, whether you want to show the name of the map or not, and whether you want to show the legend. And if you want to show the legend, what should be the location of the legend on the image that gets produced from this map. So once you make these selections, you can click on download and you'll see a downloadable file is available. So you can open this. And then this is available for you to use in your different presentations or documents. Okay, so this is where you can download the map. Okay, so I think we've covered a couple of things. So let's take 10 minutes and cover the exercises. So we have covered part 2.4. Yeah, 2.4, and we've covered part 2.5. Sorry, 2.4, 3.1, and 3.2. Okay, so let's do quickly the practice exercise for 10 minutes for these three parts, and then we proceed to the next set.
Saurabh, what is the word of the day?
Yeah, I'll just share that before we start the next part. Yeah.